Welcome everyone to Netrunner Odyssey, another episode. I am Odysseus. We're going to be bringing back some Android Netrunner today. Tonight I'm going to be playing a deck built by Code Marvelous of A&R Black Hats. It is the Shogun of the Net, he called it. It's based around hostile infrastructure. I think the basic idea is you try smash stuff, I try sure stuff. So there's loads of assets. It's a big horizontal game. You want to get your hostile infrastructures out and just tax the runner to hell. And it's not only like your standard RP tax, just money, but you're taxing them damage. This hand has got no money, but it's actually not too bad. I think we'll keep that. Do we want to keep it? Nah. We're going to draw it into something absolutely terrible now. No, we've got hostile infrastructure. We've only got one ice though, which kind of sucks. So Snake's taking a mulligan as well. He's going to be playing Edward Kim. So we're going to just go ahead, right ahead, get into the game. So we've got two hostile infrastructures, that's nice. Let's make some servers. So we're going to... Right now, we've got the Nisei. He can trash operations, which kind of sucks. I'm going to put our Tsurugi right over R&D because right now that's where the majority of our agendas are. Actually, wait. We're gonna do this instead, I think. We'll show them what we've got. We'll show them four of these. We'll get some cash. Take them back, then. We'll just play out the sewer gate over R&D and pass it over. We're going to try and do a fast game tonight. We done a test of this deck last night and the game took almost 2 hours. It was god awful. It got right down, it was an amazing game actually. It got right down to, I had 3 cards left in my deck. Snake had 0 and 0 cards in hand, and he sniped the last agenda for the win. It was pretty awesome. Okay, so he's got the Mimic out, he's got the Data Sucker out, and Daily Cast. That is good against us. But he doesn't have an Eli. Now, we're going to take a risk. We're going to pop the Eli over there. We're going to put the Nisei out, and we're going to advance it. Now, 4 credits is not enough to get through an Eli. Unless he just runs straight, well, he's drawing cards, so hopefully we're all good. Definitely use some card draw. Oh, he's drawing up. So yeah, as I said, we did play this deck last night. So Snake does know that it does a fair bit of net damage. The idea is not to kill. You very, very rarely get a kill with this deck, I think. It is possible, but it's rare. But the net damage tax hurts. So just doing last click. Just gonna check the Tsurugi, check R&D. Now we could completely make them poor, but that will also make us absolutely skint next turn. Do we want to make him poor? He's still going to get in, but let's go ahead. So it's going to cost him his 4 credits, unless he wants to take some damage. Unfortunately for us, that means we are entirely poor next turn. Unless we risk, we could probably risk leaving the Nisei out for another turn. Now it does get the Edward Kim ability. So fingers crossed. Fingers crossed it's not an agenda. Fingers crossed it's not an operation. Okay, so he's passed it over. So Komainu is now. Precarious situation. Do we wanna this is not going as fast as I hoped. Do we wanna just advance this and score it and then we've got an end of run? Or I don't think it's in any. Nah. We're gonna do this. Do this. Pass play over. So what? This deck, you absolutely do want to protect your archives, as you do with every RP game. You don't want to leave a server where they can run easily and then run your remotes. So we need to be drawn into some ice. So he's got enough to get into R&D now. Is that what he's going to do? Okay, he's going to give
it. Login rejected.
So he's going to go for this server. So go red.
Login rejected.
And it's our turn. Now we can't score this turn. He does know it's an Eli. So we're in a bit of a precarious situation. But putting that Lotus Field out could be pretty sweet. Although we do want to protect archives. Think. How's it going to work? Oh, it's slow. Now, archives or our... Yep. And... we'll do this. We can't res this, but... we'll see if the threat of it puts them off. He's gotten some money.
Login rejected.
Okay, so now we can trash one of these. Whichever one he sees. Hostile. That hurts quite a bit that it gets trashed. Or not. Why? I don't understand why he would do that.
Login rejected.
I'm not going to res that piece of ice. Oh, okay. Yeah, it was a mistake, I guess. Okay. So we got a Hokusai grid. I think what we're going to do is just absolutely make ourselves poor, but we'll get the Nisei. Hopefully we'll draw into some drip. There's a ton of drip econ in this. You've got your free sundews, which are just standard. There are two pad campaigns, I think. Free mental health clinics. So you're kind of swimming in loot later on. And once you've got your hostile infrastructures up, the runner's very loath to trash them. Now I've got zero crit. Okay, pair four. Oh, so he's taking a net damage. Okay, so did they have two of those? That was quite a good move. I've had worse. What a card. It's fantastic. So access that card, dude. He does get a C2, and I've only seen one agenda so far, so it's getting a bit meh. Might have to put the Hokusai grid up there. I didn't see anything. Parasite. Okay. I think the better play would, well, I guess maybe didn't have it in hand then, actually. But if he was to run R&D again next turn, he can just trash it because he's got the Data Sucker tokens. Damn, choices are slow tonight. I can't say anything though. I've been taking one time for my turns. He draws a card. Okay, so we've got Pup, which is not ideal. Yep, I think what we're going to do is install Hokusai for R&D and credit. So we'll take these turns, seeing as we're kind of bereft of agendas. We'll take these turns to solidify our board state. So we need to get some ice over archives, some more ice over R&D. There is, I believe there's like 8 ice, very low strength, so you've got 3 pups, I'm sure. 3 Kaminos, 3 Tsurugis probably. Tsurugis less so, but the Kaminos and the pups are supposed to be like parasite fodder, so. And then your like mid-game ice, you've got your Eli's, your Lotus Fields. And I'm sure there's a Tobuf in here and Wall of Thorns. So you want to put them on your centrals for like the long game tax. That is slow going for Kim's turn. Okay, Knight's an interesting choice. Oh, what are you doing now? It's going to make that R&D run. No. Ah, he's hosting Knight. Okay. That's pretty good. It does just break it for 2. But Eli still attacks, so we can't complain. If he'd pass play over, hopefully we'll draw into something nice this turn. So we got a Yagura. Now this is just a pure tax. It does not keep him out. But we are absolutely going to play it there. And just take 2 credits. Get rid of your parasite. Drag off the board, dude. I mean, I guess that's a good choice in the long run, but right now I've not played anything in this server. It doesn't have a barrier breaker out. This is slightly, I guess you could click through, but it's a slightly strange choice, for his knight. Getting some money. Money is. We are severely lacking money. Okay, so we got a pad campaign. Now. We're just going to take. Oh, I really want the drip, but. I think we'll do this. We'll put pup over archives. We're just going to take 2 credits. He's going to have 5 credits next turn. Let's take the risk. We'll play the pad out. We'll take a crit. Oh, wrong button. Getting that enhanced login protocol. I would love to be playing these cards right now, but we just do not have the economy going. It's hurting us quite a bit. We'll let him in. Can't trash it. Choices. The mem chip. Cool. Okay, so we got a fetal AI. We'll keep that in hand. He doesn't seem bothered about running their hand. Actually, that was a miss move. I meant to do that. And get the credit. And then for our 3 clicks, we're just going to take all the monies. So now we can, I mean, he can run and trash the pad, but quite like him to hit HQ. I mean, right now he doesn't have his barrier breaker out. So we could possibly play out enhanced login, take two credits next turn, turn after, play out our feel. We can hope. I would really like him to hit Kamino right now. Damn, he knows there's no meat damage in this deck. We went through my entire deck last night. But if he wants to spend the credits, who am I to complain? So we've got a mental health clinic. Yep, we're going to play this. We're going to play this. And we're going to take that credit. That was a complete waste of free credits, to be perfectly honest. Ah, strange that he kept that when he knows that this deck does net damage. So we've got the Zul. You can break the Yagura. Oh, Katty. That's four as well. Strange play. Oh, so we're going to res that to gain our credit, and we're going to. Yep, we're absolutely going to play out the health clinic. Do we want to play out the hostile? We'll just play it out. Just play it naked. And we're going to draw a card. So I think it doesn't have a lot of credits. Right now we're going to just push and score the Fetal. It's not one that I want to score, but Down to one credit. Is it just going to hit one of these and see what it is? In you go, dude. Thank you. Yeah, last time, played this game last night, and I sat on my agendas for so long that he'd eventually just come to us. So I think a little bit of aggression. Ah! Where is it? Take your credit. Now we've got a Kamainu. Ten credits. We need. We got to take the risk, I guess. Now he's only got one credit, he hasn't put any on Kati. So I'm not feeling too pressured at the moment. You really don't want to be scoring Fetal AIs, I hate scoring them, but meh. So I think next, after we've scored this, so the turn after we score Fetal, if we do score it, we will put our Kamainu over R&D because he does have that R&D interface and we still haven't drawn a lot of agendas. Put the Kamainu out, we'll put the Hokusai grid probably, possibly over the scoring remote. Oh, phone call. Be right back.
Login rejected.
Login rejected.